Hey everybody, my name is Jeremiah Craig, and I have another extended test review for you today, and we are looking at the Holder cowboy boot from Ariat. Let's get into it.
Old boots got soul, and I carry on this way, and we get better every day.
Quick note before I start, Ariat is also sponsoring this video, which means they paid me and sent me these boots for the purposes of this video. But it's also in my contract not to let any of those details sway my opinion during the review of these boots. But it's still something that you should know. Huge thanks to Ariat for supporting the channel. I'm really able to do so much more when brands help me out like this. So with that, let's get into the video. When I was talking with Ariat, I was originally thinking about doing a video on a different boot, but then I asked all of you out there if you were curious about Ariat's shock shield technology in the heel. And you guys overwhelmingly said, yes, that's what I wanna see. So I picked the Holder, which has that technology in it. So let's see what these are like. Here is the Holder, and wow, they do not let you miss the fact that these are the shock shield. They got it emblazoned right here with a rubber band. So if you were curious if these were really shock shield or not, they're not letting you forget. It looks like we have a lot to look over with this boot, so let's jump right into the rundown. The Holder boot is full grain leather on the vamp, counter, and shaft, and these are made in China, Ariat's, so they are a little bit stiff, similar to other made in China Ariat's that I've tried on this channel previously. We also have a wide square toe with a double stitched welt. However, I don't believe that this is a real double stitched welt. I believe they put it on there just for the look of it because the stitching does not go through to the outsole. On a lot of double stitched welts, you'll see those stitches come through down here. However, you only have one stitch line around the tread of this rubber outsole. So they say that these do have a Goodyear welt and can be resold, but I would consult with your local cobbler because there's a lot of smaller cobblers who don't want to resole Ariat's that are made in China because it's too hard. So you may have to send this to an official Ariat resoling facility and see if they'll do it. But on Ariat.com, it says that these can be resold. We have a rubber outsole here with a nice amount of tread. It's not too aggressive, but it's not like you're gonna be slipping all over the place or anything. And then for a heel, we have their special shock shield technology. Now, Ariat has been known for incorporating sneaker technology, athletic shoe technology into their cowboy boots since they started. So I'm not really surprised that they would try to do something like this to help spread out the shock from every step that you take. In fact, the co-founder and CEO of Ariat, Beth Cross, used to work at Reebok, and she actually took the idea to them to make a athletic cowboy boot, but they said, you know, we're not really into that, so that's why she started going in that direction in the cowboy boot world. And this heel is kind of what I would expect from a sneaker company making cowboy boots. It feels really nice in here. It just kind of has a little wedge of soft material. And I'm really interested to try these to feel if it really makes that big of a difference. Let's move on into the inside of the boot. And we do have a leather line, but the leather is sort of like a distressed suede feeling. Very much different from some of the other linings that we've seen. And then it feels like it could be like a canvas or a cloth lining the footbed. Now let's check out the insole. This is an insole that we haven't seen on the channel yet. This is their Energy Max insole. It's really bright. I don't know why an insole needs to be this bright. It's really eye-catching. And this is pretty much just all foam. It kind of feels like the 4LR, but has the top, the lining of a ATS. It doesn't have the nice smooth finish that the 4LR does. And it also doesn't have those nice bubbles that come with the 4LR. Feels nice, nothing too crazy. Right off the bat, my initial impressions of this is that I still like the 4LR better, but I haven't even tried this boot on yet. So let's do that and see what they feel like. All right, so I got the holders on now, and they really don't feel that much different from other Chinese-made Ariats. The leather is more stiff than what you would get from some of their Mexican-made lines, but I'm not really afraid of that because they do end up breaking in. It is a little bit less stiff than the Plano, but it's not as stiff as their Vietnam-made boots, but it's pretty much what you would expect from a Chinese-made Ariat. If you are familiar with what they make, you know how these feel already, at least with the leather. The insole is better than the ATS. I like it. You get a little bit more arch support, and I'm not really a huge fan of gel. The ATS does use gel. I feel like gel sort of makes you wobble a little bit. This does have some nice shock absorbency in the upper arch and in the heel. I'll have to really test these out with a jump or something. But for the most part, I'm getting all of the comfort at the bottom of the foot that I would expect from an Ariat, but still the stiff leather that they're known for in their Chinese-made models. It is comfortable right from the get-go. It feels like you're on a cloud, and that is what Ariat is known for, and that's what they're good at, is their insole technology. But sometimes I feel like their leather quality just isn't as good from other brands or the other lines that they have, like the Ariats that are made in Mexico. It looks pretty good so far. Let's see what happens. Extended test time. All right, so I am in the Mount Pisgah Trail area here in Massachusetts. It's about an hour west of Boston, and this is a good area to test out these Ariat holder boots because it has some nice little areas where I can jump off of. There's a lot of mountain biking that happens over here, so it seems like a lot of people have made little jumps and ramps for their mountain bikes. And I'm gonna jump off of one of those to test out this heel. But first, I gotta do my coffee and music live stream like I do every Monday morning here on YouTube.
Let's go out on the lake in our inflatable sofa and watch the world end. I got some beer and trail mix to hold us over till it's safe to start again. Darling, don't shed a tear, the apocalypse is here, but we can still grow older. We can see it turn and watch it all burn from the lake on our inflatable sofa.
I went camping with the holders last weekend, and I didn't record any of it because it was vacation. The heel is definitely noticeably softer than any other heel that I've tried, so the shock shield does make a difference, but the ball of the foot just feels unsupported. In fact, I think the Energy Max weakest point is in the ball of the foot. All right, so I found a pretty good rock here to jump off of. This is gonna be the first test because I'm gonna land on forest floor. So it's gonna be a little bit more cushioned because of all the decomposing leaves and pine needles. So I probably won't get as good of a sense of the cushioning in this heel, but it's a good place to start on how it feels landing from, I don't know, this looks like about 3 to 4 feet. So I'll jump down, set up my cameras down here, and we'll see if we can get a good reaction of the heel, and then I'll see if there's someplace else that I can jump down and land on stone and see how the shock shield reacts to that too. All right, so you couldn't really see how the shock shield reacted because I sank too deep into the forest floor, but it did feel good on my heels. And I want to go see if I can find more of a stone area where I can land so that we can capture the shock shield a little bit better.
You guys want to see something cool? This is wintergreen, the mint. And you can find it all over the place in the northeast, in the mountains. Is this in your area? Let me know. You can tell because it sort of has like a waxy leaf. And the most way that you can tell is that you break it open like this. Oh, and you can smell wintergreen. It's pretty obvious. Except it's fresher than any of the actual gums that you try, any of the chewing gums. And yes, you can eat this. Just like gum, except it tastes fresher. So now you know what wintergreen looks like. If you ever see it around, don't just stick it in your mouth right away. If you break it open, smell it, see if it is wintergreen, and then you can try it. But if you do see some, you should definitely try some. I found another little jump here that is actually meant for mountain bikes with a little bit harder surface. Not quite complete stone, but it is compact dirt on stone, so it's not as soft as the forest floor either. So I'm gonna do this as the next test. It looks like it's about the same height. A little bit more of a arc that I gotta jump, but for the most part, I think that we will see the heel react a little bit better here. I don't think I got the best footage of the shock shield heel just because of the dirt here on the forest floor, so I think I'm gonna go try it out by jumping off the back of the truck onto the driveway when I get back. But I can definitely feel that it makes an enormous difference in the heel. That cushion, it makes landing on your heel much easier and comfortable, but I can't say it does the same for the ball of the foot. The ball of my foot just feels more tired than it even does in hard leather insoles on new boots. So I can't really say that the insole does very much for the ball of the foot, but the heel and that shock shield, that's pretty cool. That's a pretty cool feeling to have such cushioning in the heel. All right, so I'm back and I'm gonna take the insoles out of this Ariat Circuit Patriot boot. And if you wanna see the review of this, you can check it out above because it is a 4LR. And I like this a lot better. It's still pretty much all foam. And I'm going to just see how it feels because this Energy Max here in the holder, the ball of the foot just doesn't feel good. So I wanna see how this one feels in the holder. All right, so I got the Ariat 4LR insole in the holder instead of the Energy Max insole. And I do like it a lot better, but there's only one way to really see how it feels, and that's by jumping off the back of the truck. And maybe I'll be able to get a little bit better footage of that shock shield in action. All right, so you were able to see the shock shield compression on the heel of this holder much better on the asphalt from jumping off the truck than what you saw in the woods jumping off those rocks. But I'm still feeling like this just needs way more support in the ball of the foot. I mean, they tried so hard to make so much cushioning in the heel, but there's just nothing for the ball of the foot at all. Even with these 4LRs, sure, it's feeling a little bit better. For the most part, it's just left out there hanging in the world, ready to get hurt, and the ball of my foot is just exhausted, and I haven't even been in these things all day. So I think there definitely is room for improvement, but the shock shield in the heel is very comfortable. Now, let's go to my final thoughts.
Overall, it's not bad. You know, I like the leather that they're using. It's not as stiff as some of the other boots that Ariat is making in China. Definitely not as stiff as the Plano was, so it's breaking in a lot faster and isn't as cumbersome to wear during the break-in process. The outsole is nice. It's got a nice amount of grip to it. I didn't find myself slipping too much in the woods or on the rocks or anything, whether I was camping or doing the jump test. Lining is different. It's kind of suede-y, like I said at the beginning of the video, and it makes it just a little bit warmer than some of the other Ariats that are coming out of China too. This shock shield thing is great, but I wish they could put a shock shield thing up here as well, because I feel like there's a lot of pressure that's just focused right here because so much pressure is taken off the heel. And the Energy Max insole really doesn't make up for anything. I would have to say that
It is my least favorite insole from Aerie that I've tried thus far. I like the 4LR the best, and they were a little bit more comfortable with the 4LR in here, but I was still feeling a lot of pressure on the ball of my foot. The Energy Max didn't help it. I kinda wanna try it with some ATS insoles, except I just don't have any ATS insoles around right now. Overall, I would say that the hard leather insoles on cowboy boots, like a traditionally made cowboy boot, is still more comfortable than what this is with its Energy Max insole. But I still had fun with them. They're a nice boot to go hiking in, especially on the heel. But like I said, the ball of the foot is the only problem that I have with this boot and the only thing that I have against it. So if you're interested in getting the Holder boot, the links are in the description. If you are coming at this video within days of it being published, right now Ariat is running a special sale, a special promotion for Labor Day. So you can check out that link in the description as well. Are they worth the $220, $250? I would say yes, but I would still prefer a traditionally made boot over this one, and maybe even the Plano over this, just because it was a lot lighter and it just felt better to wear all day. I didn't have as many problems on the ball of the foot that I did with this one from any other area that I've ever tried. So I'm not sold on this completely, definitely not my favorite boot, but very interesting technology in this heel, which definitely works. It's just I wish they had similar technology at the ball of the foot. Let me know what you think of the Ariat Holder boots down in the comments. Thank you so much for watching today, and a huge thanks to Ariat for sponsoring this video and helping support the channel. I'll see you guys around. Peace.
Holder, holder. Jumping off boulders, landing on the shock shield. Holder, holder, good on your joints if you're older, but I still felt it in the ball instead of the heel. Oh, my name is Jeremiah Craig. Thank you for watching today. Don't forget to subscribe while you're here. It's right down below. Huge thanks to Ariat for supporting the channel. It goes a long way, don't you know? Yeah.
Peace, everybody. Have a good one.